Good day, Internet, and welcome to Fishing for Icebergs. Today I'm just going to be doing a little tutorial on how to use some basic soul shards in the Feed the Beast packs. Now, my design today is slightly out of date. It is based on the Red Power Transposer and the old-fashioned soul shards, although the newer soul shards work just as well. For those of you who are using the more up-to-date Feed the Beast packs, it is just as possible to achieve this method using buildcraft pipes, except instead of the transposers, you would need a setup of obsidian and iron pipes, as shown here. This being the ground level of your drop trap. The trap today is based on sort of dropping, essentially. The idea being that from a soul cage at this height, enemies will drop, and the fall damage, having killed them, will allow the transposers to pick up their gubbins, for want of a better word. Now, this 9x9 arrangement is the maximum size of this sort of spawner. None of the enemies will spawn outside of this range. However, as you can see in the back line here, if you are using the red power option, there is the problem whereby the redstone doesn't reach far enough, in which case you need to use a secondary timer, just sort of like that. When all of the gubbins are picked up after the enemies are dead, they will go through the pipes to whatever storage device you have on hand. This is the main advantage of the red power version of the pipes, as they are considered more intelligent, in that they will only go to where there is available inventory space, whereas the buildcraft pipes shown over here require you to micromanage their movement. So if we just get it to work quickly, we have the soul cage up here, and these are soul shards. Now, the soul shards that you get from the soul forge in this one, or from the endstone arrangement in the newer versions of the soul shard mod, look like this to start with. Obviously, the higher level the soul shard, which is just based on how many of the enemy you kill, the better the bonuses and the spawn rate. For instance, this one is a tier 5 from 1024 kills. Now, for this demonstration, I'm just going to use a zombie pigman, just because that's nice and easy. And if I kill him now, yay, dead. Bastard. You see that this soul shard has now been bound to zombie pigman. Whereas before it was blank, now it is a zombie pigman shard. Using this at the top of this structure, you can now see that the zombie pigmen spawn, fall, and die. It's a slightly morbid system, but very effective. Obviously, in a real version of this, where I wasn't trying to show you the transposer and pipe arrangement, you would have a layer of stone bricks like this, as that would be better for collecting the items by propping them on the level of the transposer's collection, which is one higher than their upward face. And as you can see, very quickly, even with the incomplete floor, the system starts collecting rotten flesh and golden nuggets, which you can then use in your base for whatever means necessary. It is a very large structure, and obviously it would be better if there was some sort of smaller version that was more discreet. And so in a later video, I will show you some of the more advanced soul shard based traps to allow you to capture zombie drops in a more space saving way. Now, if you have liked the video, please, well, press all the appropriate buttons, which I won't say or list off because that'd be condescending. Thank you for watching Fishing for Icebergs, and I will see you next time.